So nowadays, social media is flooded with pictures like their old age, the pictures with smile, as you can see in the screen, which is all about the FaceApp. The FaceApp, like you upload a picture and you will get the older version of yourself or the better version of yourself. So what is FaceApp, by the way? So FaceApp is a mobile application for iOS and Android developed by Russian company which is Wireless Lab, and which uses machine learning algorithm neural network technology to automatically generate highly realistic transformations of faces in photographs. And this app can also transform face it to make it smile, look younger, you look older, or change gender too. So as you can see in the screen, like this is the present version of this man, and this app converts how you will look if you get old. Similar to this is the normal face and this is the face with the smile. So how this app works? So first of all, they have created one algorithm which they have a bunch of images. For example, here you can see the image of Donald Trump, which how he was looking in 1980 and how he is looking in 2018. So they have given the image of present, the younger one, and the older image of that person, and machine will generate patterns according to those images. Like thousands of images are given to that algorithm, and that algorithm will find patterns into that, and this will upgrade its accuracy of this algorithm. And if you input any new photo, and it will generate the output according to that algorithm. So this is how FaceApp works. Now, as you can see, like there are also filters on Instagram, Snapchat, like face filter on Snapchat, and some other filters on Instagram too. So those filters are done into the your mobile phone only. They don't have to upload photos onto their servers. But FaceApp, what FaceApp does, there is a data in your phone. You select the photo, and which is uploaded to their servers like AWS, Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud. And there is also you can see in the screenshot, like each photo you select for editing will be uploaded our servers for image processing and face transformation. They have told like why they want to upload this photo on the server, because it needs high processing power. Generally, mobile phones cannot do this if effects on the mobile of the general images. So they need to upload these pictures onto the servers. And yeah, so in recent days, criticisms are occurred. And so FaceApp attracted criticism both the press and the social media over the privacy of user data. So they are questioned about like what they are doing with their images, what they are like doing with the data. Also, US Senator Chuck Schumer expressed serious concerns regarding both the protection of the data that is being aggregated as well as whether users are aware of who may have access to it, and also called for an FBI investigation into the app. So you can see the level of criticism has occurred for this application. So before coming to this question, if FaceApp safe or not, let's get into the conversations between Washington Post columnist Geoffrey A. Fowler and FaceApp CEO Yaroslav Gonkarov. So what do they tell into that interview? They told like what the first question was, what data do they take? So FaceApp uploads and process photos in the cloud, and but the app will only upload a photo selected by a user. It will not upload the whole camera, whole gallery pictures onto their cloud. You have to select which photo you want to upload. They will process upload that photo, and they will process it. And you can also use FaceApp without giving it your name or email. So you don't have to register first. So it will be not linked. It will not map your image with your name. And 99% of users do just that, he said. The second question was, how long do they hold on your data? So Gonkarov said like FaceApp deletes most of the data photos from its servers after 48 hours. So here is the question: what is the meaning of most of the pictures? Is it like some how they select some pictures? And so it's a one more question. And the third question was like, what are they doing with your data? Is FaceApp using our faces and maps it to make them for anything other than express purpose of the app, such as running facial identification for us? So he said no, but in legally the app's terms gave it to write do whatever it wants. In its policy, they have written like irrevocable, non-exclusive, royalty-free, worldwide, fully paid, transferable, sub-licensable license. So it is clearly mentioned in their user policy. So this also one more thing. And who has access to your data? Do government authorities in Russia have access to our photos? No. Because he said like FaceApp's engineers are based in Russia. They are based in Russia, so our data is not transferred there. That doesn't mean that the data is transferred into Russia only. He said the company also doesn't sell or share any user data with any third parties. This was his answer. So in summary, what we have done, what we have just analyzed about this privacy of this app. The first thing, what was that the privacy concerns have grown in recent days. And the face transformation tool is swiftly becoming the global viral sensation. As you can see, like the social media and the social medias in the newspapers, also the celebrities are trying this FaceApp challenge. Users were cautioned that the app, which allows users to see their future self by using artificial intelligence software to rework photos and could be used to harvest data for nefarious purpose by its Russian-based developers. And yet, FaceApp said in a statement that no user data is transferred to Russia and that it deletes images after 48 hours after they have uploaded to its servers. And data is not being shared with any third party. This was what the summary of this video and what I think about this is application is safe or not. Now you have to decide like, is it a safe app or not? It's up to you. You have to read this user agreements, privacy policies, and according to that decide that if you want to use FaceApp or not, is it safe for you or not. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Share this video if you think this is helpful for you and for also other people. Thank you so much.